This is our BMW 3 Series and in this video we're going to change its front brakes. So for this job we'll need a few basic tools such as a socket set, an axle stand, a car jack and a big breaker bar. First off we start by breaking loose the wheel bolts. And take extra care when loosening the locking wheel nut. And now we need to find our jacking point. Typically BMWs have a jacking pad in the corners of the sills. Yeah, ours appear to be missing, but it's no matter, we'll just use the space where they're meant to be. So we start by getting the car in the air, till the wheels are about an inch off the ground. It's important to use an axle stand for this, you don't want the jack to fail. We then continue to remove the wheel ball. Firstly, remove the retention clip. There will be two Allen head bolts on the back. You will need to remove the rubber caps first. Then it's just a case of prising the caliper from the disc. If the disc and pads were low, then we need to compress the piston, but since they're still new, we should be fine. And here's our old pads. You can still see they have plenty of meat left on them, but we'll be changing them for some padded ones to match with our new discs. Next is a locating bolt. Be careful with this as it's easily rounded. A nice trick here is to wedge a screwdriver in the vent of the disc, and that'll stop the disc spinning when trying to remove that bolt. After that we have two 18mm bolts holding the bracket on. These are often extremely tight and after much pulled muscles and hurt egos, we still couldn't remove it. So we got creative. Then after a quick cry, we tried again. And it finally came loose. And then the same again for the other bolt, and we're good to go. And the disc is finally off. The hub itself isn't overly rusty, but it's always a good idea to give it a quick clean with a wire brush. And here's a quick side-by-side comparison of our old discs and our new discs. This would be a great point to give the bracket a quick clean. Give the hub a quick rub of grease. And at this point it's just a reversal of everything we've just done. Line the disc up so the holes are aligned. Nip up the retention bolt. Grease up the caliper bracket. Reattach the bracket. Grease up the pads. Be sure to put the pad with a metal clip into the piston and not to get any grease on the friction surface. grease up the other pad and put it in the bracket. Put the caliper back on, ensuring the bolts line up to the bracket, and tighten them. Put back on the retention clip. Bolt the wheels back on. You can now take the stand out from under the car and lower the jack, and then torque the bolts down to spec. And this side is done. And then it's just a case of doing the same thing to the other side. Usually there'd be a brake wear sensor, but in our case that was broken, so we'd be changing that another time. Now that both sides are done, you'll need to pump the brake pedal a few times till it's hard and you're good to go. For the first 50 to 100 miles, you will need to take it easy for the brakes to bed in. Now, no more brake jitter. If you like this video, give this video a like and consider subscribing. We do have more car content coming, so stay tuned.